Everyone knows dry ice is super cold, and our mega solar scorcher is super hot. So what happens if they go up against each other in a battle? Guys, we've had literally hundreds, possibly thousands of comments asking to see what happens if we pit dry ice against our mega solar scorcher. So today, that is what we're doing. Here's the basic idea. We will take the solar scorcher and we'll focus it right on the surface of the dry ice. After that, we'll try taking some dry ice, breaking it up into a powder, and focusing the solar scorcher on that. We will then try focusing it on lead, on pennies, and on a steel plate sitting on top of the dry ice to see which one wins. The extreme cold of the dry ice or the extreme heat of the mega solar scorcher. I have a good setup on our solar scorcher, so we should be able to set things down right where we want them and focus the beam right where we want it without having to hold on to it too long. I've got some welding glasses so I can look carefully and focus the point right where I want it for maximum heat. I think at this point we just have to try it. Our old solar scorcher frame had started to break down and the lens had gotten cloudy. So this is our new frame and our new lens, the all new Mega Solar Scorcher 2.0. We're gonna try and break this block of dry ice in half, and we'll put half of it under the beam and we'll put half of it off to the side as a control so we can see the difference of having the light focused on it or not focused on it. Just like with the mini solar scorcher, this bolt works as a marker to show us when it's focused. It's perfectly perpendicular to our screen, so once we get the shadow to disappear completely, we know that we've got our lens pointed right at the sun. Dry ice reflects a lot of light. It's very white, so it may not retain the heat very well. That's why this is an experiment. Let's find out what happens. Got my welding goggles, normal sunglasses. Don't cut it. Here goes.
We have a dot focused right on the surface of that dry ice.
It definitely looks like there's more vapors coming off of the brick that has the sunlight focused on it. Just as a quick test to show that this is hot, I'm gonna stick a stick right in that focal point. And the stick is burning, and it's on fire. Well, there you go. About 2 seconds in the sunlight to light on fire. Very nice and hot. Standing behind it here, put my regular sunglasses on because I'm not looking right at the point, but just that whole brick of dry ice is just glowing. A lot of the light is shining right down through it. Just getting near. It's so warm. Over here, not so much. Here's the block of dry ice that was sitting in the focal point of our solar death ray, and here's the block of ice that was just sitting off to the side as a control, and they look the same. The one that was in the focal point really hasn't changed much. It didn't seem to sublimate any noticeable amount faster. For the most part, I'm gonna say that the heat from the solar scorcher didn't do much, and it was sitting in that focal point for about 20 minutes. I think the solid white nature of this hard carbon dioxide just isn't much affected by the heat from our solar scorcher. Let's try taking a piece of the dry ice, crushing it into powder, and seeing if that does anything when focused under the lens. That looks like a pretty good pile of dry ice powder. Let's focus our death ray on it and see if it does anything. There we go. Beautifully in the focal point. Wood lights almost instantly. Dry ice lights less. After 15 minutes of our dry ice powder sitting under the solar scorcher, it's just powder. Nothing's really happened to it. It may have sublimated a little bit faster than normal, but now we know that for the most part, a solar scorcher focused on some dry ice powder won't do too much to it. Next up, there are three types of metal we're gonna test as a control without dry ice. This is a plate of steel, these are some lead fishing sinkers, and this is a penny. This penny is from 2011, which means it's mostly made of zinc with a thin copper coating. All right, ready? There we go, penny in the focal point. And it's destroyed. That took all of about 3 seconds to be completely ruined. Ooh! Oh, and now it's doing something else. I think the zinc is actually burning from the heat of the solar scorcher. Don't want to breathe that in. Oh, I can't really push it anymore because this penny is actually liquid. Sweet! Love it. All right, this time I have a stack of pennies and I'm just gonna slide those right into the focal point. The height makes it so it's not quite as focused, but that top penny has still already been destroyed. This is now a barely contained pile of molten metal. I'm just gonna smush it. The pennies melted very easily, and now we're going to try lead, which actually has a much lower melting point. So I suspect this is gonna go almost instantly.
It is bubbling and it is melted. Yep, took just a couple of seconds and that thing is just liquid. Runny silver metal.
Well, pennies and lead just liquefy in seconds. Let's try something a little bit more resistant, a plate of steel. Now the solar scorcher does not get hot enough to liquefy this, but I'm betting we see a little bit of deformation, maybe some discoloration, and overall it is going to get hot.
Well, there's the discoloration I was talking about.
Steel plate is nice and hot. Let's drip some water on and watch what happens.
Just immediately skitters right off, laden frost, full in effect. Boiling instantly.
Take that plate off and see what it looks like.
Ooh, we did get deformation. That plate is not flat anymore. It's not terribly warped, but it's changed shape a bit.
We've now seen what happens focusing the full power of our solar scorcher on pennies, on some lead sinkers, and on a steel plate. Let's see what happens if we place each of those on top of dry ice and then focus our death ray on it. Our penny is lined up nicely with where the focal point will be. It's sitting on the dry ice, and at this point, it is extremely cold. Let's learn what happens if we add a little bit of heat. And by a little bit, I mean a lot. A whole big lot.
Penny is in the death ray. Or at least very close to in the death ray. Now it's in the death ray. Oh, it's spinning. I didn't see that coming. Ooh, it's getting destroyed. The surface of the penny is bubbling and burning the same way it did on the paver stone. And now the penny, because it got so hot, is tunneling through the dry ice. That is crazy. Let's poke it with a stick for science. That was amazing. Let's try it with a stack of pennies.
As the molten pennies tunnel through the dry ice, of course, they somewhat leave the focal point of the solar scorcher. Interestingly, I think a single penny tunneled a bigger hole than a stack of five pennies.
All right, we are focused on the lead.
That is some bubbly, warm metal. Very, very liquid. As it's tunneling down through the dry ice, some little bits of lead are becoming separated from the rest, and those parts are solidifying again quite easily.
The lead melted super easily.
And once it was molten metal, it tunneled down through the dry ice pretty quickly. We've got some great cavities, both from where the pennies were and from where the molten lead was. Pouring some water down onto our plate, it has cooled off to the point that it no longer is evaporating quickly. I kind of want to just leave it here for a second longer until it gets so cold again that all of that water freezes. The ice on our steel plate has now frozen all the way through, and I'm just going to refocus the solar scorcher on it and see how long that ice stays solid.
Ooh, I hear sizzling. I think that ice is not gonna stay ice for long. It's gone. So there's our steel plate being hit with the full force of our solar scorcher sitting on top of a block of dry ice. Which do you think is gonna win? Do you think the plate will get hot, or do you think it's gonna stay cold?
A steel plate that just a minute ago was so cold that water froze in a matter of seconds now just boils that water almost instantly.
In a direct fight, the solar scorcher versus the dry ice, the solar scorcher didn't seem to have much power at all, but when you had an intermediary of a metal,
it really seemed to kick the dry ice's trash. What do you guys think? Do you think the dry ice won or the solar scorcher won? Guys, that's not all we've got for you. This little box up at the top will transport you directly to our last video. You should go check that out. And the box at the bottom will show you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. Not to mention that this bomb here in the center will subscribe you to our channel so you never miss out on a video again. Don't forget to ring that bell and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.